After careful and extensive review of all options, the company has made the very difficult decision to eliminate some positions across the home improvement business. Unfortunately, your position has been among those selected for elimination.
This is unbelievable. We just spent 3 weeks training for this.
Getting fired isn't the end of the world. In fact, it could be the start of something better. I know this firsthand. I'm a 32-year-old black woman who owns a successful New York-based PR and media company in an industry mostly run by white men. Before I became my own boss, I spent years in corporate America where I faced firings, layoffs, and unfair dismissals. But through those challenges, I found resilience and a renewed sense of purpose. If you're struggling to bounce back after losing your job, here are 10 tips that helped me turn my setbacks into comebacks. 1. Grieve, feel every emotion. Cry, scream, laugh, whatever helps you release.
Don Lemon says Elon Musk canceled his deal after X, with X after tense interview. This is a CNN story, and we got a couple clips that we want to show you, but let me first read the story to you, and then we go to the clips. Don Lemon said Wednesday that his partnership with Elon Musk went down the flames hours after the former CNN anchor conducted an interview last week with the erratic billionaire for the debut episode of his new independent web-based show. Elon publicly encouraged me to join X with a new show, saying I would have his full support, Lemon said in a statement, adding that he took Musk at his word that he was interested in working directly with diverse voices. In an interview with CNN's Aaron Burnett on Wednesday, Lemon spoke about his exchange with Musk and shared video excerpts from the 90-minute sit-down in which Lemon asked Musk questions on an array of topics. Lemon said he pressed Musk about the rise in hate speech on X since billionaire took over the social media platform, asking him if he believed that he and the company had a responsibility to moderate hateful content. Rob, do you have any of the clips here that we can show? So how many of you guys saw this interview with CNN that he did yesterday? Who watched the entire thing? Did you guys watch the entire thing?
I did not watch
it. I watched the whole thing. It's actually very interesting. Well, that's the promo, right? He's kind of talking about being canceled. Do you have another one outside of that? So this is him on CNN, kind of giving a glimpse of what the conversation was like. Go ahead and play this clip, Rob. That one that you got right there.
This is just real quick. This is an excerpt from the interview where he talks about interviewing Donald, or speaking with Donald Trump. He's
Go
asking
ahead, play
Elon.
The clip. Let's see some of the stuff that they spoke
you
about.
You recently met with Donald Trump in Florida. What did you guys talk about?
I was at a breakfast at a friend's place, and Donald Trump came by. That's it.
What did you discuss?
Let's just say he did most of the talking.
Did he ask you for money?
He didn't.
Are you going to loan him money to help pay his legal bills?
I'm not paying his legal bills in any way, shape, or form.
Did he ask you for a donation?
No.
Are you leaning towards anyone?
No.
You're not leaning towards anyone? Because you've been very...
Well, I'm leaning away from Biden.
You're leaning
from Biden?
Well said.
From Biden, he said?
Yeah.
He said
I'm leaning away from Biden. Somebody. Oh. Meaning like, you know, gotcha. He definitely doesn't
Did he
wanna...
say Biden?
He didn't send Biden. Okay. He said from someone. Go ahead and play this other clip, and then we'll react to it. Go ahead. I mean,
more like a deposition interview.
Yeah, I agree. Go ahead.
Do you believe that X and you have some responsibility to moderate hate speech on the platform? That you wouldn't have to answer these questions from reporters about the Great Replacement Theory as it relates to
Democrats?
I don't
have to answer these questions.
The Great Replacement Theory as it relates to Jewish people. Do you think that...
I don't have to answer questions from reporters. Don, the only reason I'm doing this interview is because you're on the X platform, and you asked for it. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, I would not do this interview.
So you don't think? Do you think that you wouldn't get in trouble, or you wouldn't be criticized for these things?
I'm criticized constantly. I could care less.
Illuminating in so many ways. All right, I have two things I want to ask you about that, Don. First, the Great Replacement Theory.
You can pause it right there. You can pause it right there. So, Tom, reaction to this interview.
Well, first of all, it kind of disappoints me. Don Lemon is a professional. It didn't seem
losing a job can shake your confidence, but bottling up your emotions won't help. Let them out in a healthy way so you can start healing without spiraling into self-doubt. 2. Unplug from social media. Social media can be a trap, leading you to compare your life to others. After my firing, I took breaks from endless scrolling, and it was one of the best things I did for my mental health. Instead of wasting time online, I spent it with loved ones and reconnected with nature. 3. Focus on self-care. Get up, hit the gym, or go for a walk. Moving your body can work wonders for your mind. Exercise helps release stress, boosts your mood, and brings clarity. And if you can, take a break from your routine. Treat yourself to a getaway or staycation to recharge and refocus. 4. Don't rush into another job. It's tempting to find another job right away, especially with bills piling up. but taking the first offer out of desperation could sidetrack your long-term goals. Slow down, file for unemployment, and take the time to think about your next move. 5. Remember, a job doesn't define you. You are so much more than a paycheck. Jobs are stepping stones, not the end goal. When I got fired, it sparked the idea of starting my own business. The skills I gained from those corporate jobs, I used them to build something for myself. You can do the same. 6. Reinvent yourself. Being fired is an opportunity to start fresh. Instead of feeling stuck, think of this as a chance to realign your life. Refresh your resume, update your LinkedIn, and map out your next steps. But don't forget to work on yourself too. 7. Make a plan. Without a plan, it's easy to fall back into the same patterns. Create a vision board or write down your career goals. Plot out how you're going to get there and hold yourself accountable. Use the same energy you once gave to your corporate job to invest in your future. 8. Rebuild your confidence. Getting fired doesn't define your worth. It's just one door closing, which means another one is about to open. Write down your strengths and accomplishments to remind yourself of what you bring to the table. Sometimes even a new haircut or wardrobe can help boost your confidence. 9. Lean on your network. Your connections can be your biggest asset. Don't hesitate to reach out to past coworkers or mentors for support. Most of my current clients came from people I worked with before. Even the CEO who fired me once became one of my partners years later. 10. Start applying, but be selective. When you're ready, start applying for jobs, but don't rush. Be discerning about which roles you pursue and take the time to research companies before applying. Persistence is key, and patience will pay off in the long run.